Hello and welcome back. Today we are going to start with the second chapter of civics. Do you remember the vertical division of power which we have done in the first chapter? Here, look at this flowchart again. As you can see here, in the vertical division of power, levels of the government are divided at three levels. Union or central government, state government, or local self-government. Commonly, it is known as a federal system of government. Now, here in this second chapter, we are going to focus on this vertical division of power only. Now, what is federalism or a federal system of government? Federalism is a system of government in which power is divided between central and various constituent units of the country. Federation have two levels of government. One is the government for entire country. The other are governments at the level of provinces or states. Both these levels of the government have separate powers. Now, do we have only this one system of government in democracies? No. Some of the democratic nations also practice a unitary system of government or governance. Now, what is this unitary system of governance? Under the unitary system, there is only one level of government, or the subunits or subordinate, they are subunits or the subordinate to the central government. Here, central government can pass order on the provincial, that is the state, or local governments. Now, let us see what are the key features of federalism. First and the most important key feature of federalism is that there are two or more levels of the government. Each level of government has its own jurisdiction. Now, what is jurisdiction? The area over which someone has legal authority comes under the jurisdiction of that authority. The jurisdiction of each level of the government are specified in the constitution. The fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be changed without the consent of both the levels of the government. Now, what could happen if these two levels of the government disagree on any subject? Or if there is any kind of dispute between them, courts have the power to interpret the constitution and explain or interpret the powers of different levels of the government. Sources of revenue for each level of the government are clearly specified. So, in federal system, it has dual objectives. One, to safeguard and promote the unity of the country and accommodate regional diversities also. Now, how do these countries decide that which form or the type of government they have to, establish after establishing a democracy? Is there only one type of federal form of government? Or there are other types of federal forms of government also. So, the forms of federal government basically depends on the historical background most of the time. The exact balance of power between central and the state government varies from country to country. It depends mainly on their origin. This balance there are basically two kinds of, you know, or the forms of federation in the world. One is coming together, second is holding together. Now we will see first the coming together federations. In such federations, independent states come together on their own to form a bigger unit. Let's see the example of USA. They were all independent states when they emerged as the free nation. Then on their own, they came together to form a federation, a strong nation, USA, that is United States of America. In this type of federation, all the constituent states have equal power. Together they make the federation, federal government, strong. Examples of such nations are USA, Australia, and Switzerland. Now let's see the second form of federation, which is known as holding together federations. Large countries decides to divide its power between the constituent units, these states, and the national government. Let's see the example of India. When we got independence, we emerged as one large nation with no division of power among different constituent units, that is states. Then we decided to decide the power between the different constituent units, that is states, as India is a large nation with multiple diversities. The central government tend to be more powerful than the state governments in such arrangements. Different constituent units have unequal powers. For example, as you can understand with the flow chart of vertical division of power, that in such form of government, that is holding together federations, central government have more power in comparison to state government. And then, as in case of India, we have third level of power also. So the power of local self-governments are less in comparison to state governments. Let's see the example of the countries which fall under such holding together federations. India, Spain, and Belgium are the countries who formed their government on the basis of holding together federations. Now this is all for today. I want you to go through this video carefully and have a productive day. Take care, stay safe, see you again.